Hey there, Joey here for School of Motion, and in this lesson, we'll be taking a look at the basics of expressions in After Effects. If you've never used expressions before, or even if you have, but maybe need a little refresher, this lesson will get you going in the right direction. We'll check out what expressions are, how to use them, and why, as a MoGraph artist, you need to know about them. Don't forget to sign up for a free student account so you can grab the project files and expressions from this lesson, as well as assets from any other lesson on the site. And now, let's jump in. So if you look at this comp here, you'll see that I've set up a really, really simple scene with a background and a clock, and I've already done the Photoshop work of separating out the hour and minute hands of the clock. And I've also set the anchor point appropriately to the center of rotation of the two hands. So if I rotate the minute hand, you'll see that it rotates exactly as it should. So if you were asked to animate a scene that had a clock in it, there's an easy way to do it, but there's some pitfalls with that easy way, and I'm going to show you that right now. So obviously, the easiest way would be to set a keyframe on the rotation property at the beginning. So let's do that. And then to go, you know, forward in the comp and change the value. So now you have two keyframes. All right. So you can see that this works. However, let's say that you want a very exact speed for the amount of rotation of the minute hand. Let's say that you want, you know, one rotation every 2.5 seconds or something like that. Well, now it gets a little bit trickier because now you have to say, okay, well, how long is my comp? Well, this comp is 2 minutes long. If I'm having one rotation every 2.5 seconds, then what does this value need to be? And you have to do math, and no one likes to do math. So when you're using keyframes, it's good if you're doing short little bursts of animation. But when you're doing things like this, where you need a constant motion throughout the length of your comp, expressions are a much better way to do it. So I'm just going to use this as an example of how to apply an expression and sort of how you can work with expressions in After Effects. So let's get rid of this keyframe and let's zero this back out. So the first thing we want to do is actually enable an expression on this layer. All right. And expressions are applied to keyframeable properties like position, scale, rotation, transparency, or if you had an effect on this layer, you could apply expressions to the properties of the effect. So you can use them a lot of ways. So the one way you can apply an expression is to click on the property that you want to add the expression to, go to the animation menu, and hit add expression. All right. I'm a big fan of hotkeys, and whenever possible, I'm going to try and teach you guys some really useful hotkeys, because if you're trying to freelance or impress your employer or just get a job, one of the best things that you can do as a motion graphics artist is get quicker and be able to work faster and build things faster. And hotkeys are probably the number one way to do that, because when you get the hang of them, you'll find that you start doing them without even thinking about it, and you can work almost as fast as you can think. And that's really important. So the way I add expressions is I hold the Option key, and by the way, I'm on a Mac. On a PC, I would imagine that's the Alt key. So you hold Option and you click Rotation, and now we've enabled an expression for that. You can see the value of rotation turned red, and we've got this box over here where we can type our expression in. Now, the fastest way to use expressions is to kind of learn the 4 or 5 or 6 that you use most often and just kind of memorize them. And it's not as hard as it sounds. After you use an expression 2 or 3 times, you'll probably remember it. But if you forget, or if you're just new to expressions and you're not even sure what expressions are out there, this little arrow can be your buddy, because you can click this arrow and After Effects has a built-in dictionary of all of the different expression variables and functions that you can use. And it even gives you hints about how to use them. You'll see some of these functions have extra kind of options that are inside of parentheses. And that tells you that if you use, for example, this random function, which returns a random number, you need to add a parentheses and put the minimum value or array, comma, and then the maximum value or array. So you may not totally understand that yet at this point, but just bear with me. This will all make sense. Just know that once you start using expressions, if you suspect that an expression exists to do what you want, you can look through this menu and you might just find it. So what we want to do is find a way to have the rotation increase at a constant rate throughout the comp. All right. Now, the best trick I know to do that is to tie the rotation to something that's already naturally moving, you know, increasing at a constant rate, and that would be the time of the comp. All right, and you can find the variable for the comp time in the global section here. It's just time, or we can type it in. This one's pretty easy to remember. So we type in time, and a good habit to get into is adding a semicolon at the end of all of your expressions. If you have a one-line expression like time, you technically don't need to use the semicolon, but once you get into multi-line expressions, After Effects will require every line to have a semicolon, otherwise it sort of doesn't know where one line ends and the next one begins. When you're editing your expressions to commit them, on the Mac, you can hold Command and hit Return, or you can hit the return that's on the number pad. And on a PC, it would be whatever the equivalent keystroke is for Command. It's probably Control. So now, as we scrub through this, you'll see that the minute hand is moving at a constant speed. It's moving very slowly, but it's moving, you know, at the same speed the entire length of the comp. And this is great because if all of a sudden I needed to make this comp 10 minutes long, I wouldn't have to change anything. It would still be animating at that same speed. Now, the reason it's going so slow is because this time variable, it returns the comp time in seconds. So if we go to 5 seconds, for example, you'll see that the rotation is set to 5. And the reason that I know this is because I have used the expression reference many, many times. And this is where you want to go if you want to use an expression but you're not sure how. There's actually pretty good documentation for it. And there's also some great websites out there that will help you learn to do this stuff. And there's a lot of great sort of pre-built expressions that people have put out there for free, and you can use them, and they're very helpful. And I'll put some links to those in this blog post. So back to our expression, time is not doing it for us. It's making the minute hand move too slowly. So with expressions, you can do simple math very easily. So what if we took that value, time, and we multiplied it by a number to increase the rate at which the minute hand's turning? So let's say that we wanted the minute hand to make one complete rotation every 3 seconds. So what that means is we would need it to turn 360 degrees in 3 seconds. So hopefully you can do simple math because it is helpful. So if you divide 360 into 3 seconds, it's 120 degrees per second. All right. So every second we want to multiply whatever time it is times 120. To multiply things in After Effects, you use the asterisk. When you're doing math, you use the plus sign, the minus sign, the asterisk for multiplication, and a forward slash for division. And those are the four operators that you'll use most of the time. So if we type in time times 120, hold command and hit return, you'll see now that minute hand is moving much faster. And you can see every 3 seconds, if we go to 3, we have had one rotation in 3 seconds. All right? So now let's focus on the hour hand. So for the hour hand, I'm going to hit R to open up the rotation properties. I'm going to hold Option, click Rotation to add an expression. So now the hour hand, we need the same idea. We just need it to move slower. So let's type in time times. So now, you know, you just got to kind of use a little bit of logic here. If the minute hand rotates once around this, how far does the hour hand go? Well, it goes from one number to the next, right? So there's 12 numbers. So that means basically divide that circle into 12 pieces, right? So really, I just need to divide this number, 120, by 12. So that's how far it'll move. So 120 divided by 12 is 10. That's pretty easy. And so now you can see here we're at 9 o'clock. And that minute hand's going to go all the way around. And now we're at 10 o'clock. All right. So we have now set up an accurately functioning clock with no keyframes. This clock could go, you know, as long as we make this comp. We could make this an hour and this clock would just keep running indefinitely. And it would always tell the right time, which is great. So this is just a quick example of how expressions can be useful and can save you a lot of time. If you had to keyframe this, it would be a pain. And before we end the tutorial, I want to show you one other quick thing about tutorials that's about expressions. That's probably my favorite thing about expressions. And this is the ability to set up controls for things like this. And I'll show you what I mean by that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a null object, right? And if you don't use null objects, you should get in the habit of using them. They are just objects in After Effects that have no image associated with them. They don't look like anything, but they're sort of like a utility layer. And you can use them to parent things, you know, I can get into this in a later tutorial, but a lot of times they would be used, for example, to parent the minute hand, hour hand, and clock to a null so that now you can move the null and it moves the entire clock. So you don't have to move all three layers. But what I'm going to use it for here is to add some controls for the clock. So what I'm going to do is rename this controls. And what I want to be able to control is the speed that the clock is turning. And I want to be able to control the minute hand and the hour hand with one control. So with expressions, this is pretty easy. If you go up to the effect menu, you'll see this expression controls area. And if you've never used expressions, you've probably never used these controls. They are effects that on their own don't do anything, but you can use them to drive other layers and other properties. So what I'm going to do is pick the slider control. And you can go through and try out all of these controls, and you'll be able to see what they look like, and it may give you an idea of what they could control for you. The slider control just gives you one value that you can change, and you can slide it or you can type in a number. And this doesn't do anything on its own. However, it could drive something else. So let's rename this slider control clock speed. So now, if we open up this layer, go to effects and go to clock speed, and just so you know, the hotkey for that would be E. And E brings up any effects that are on a layer. And we open up this arrow here so we can see the slider. And the reason we need to do that is because we are actually going to link the speed of the minute hand to this slider. So I'm going to click the minute hand layer and I'm going to hit U. U is probably the most used hotkey in After Effects. You should definitely know that one. It opens up any keyframed or properties that have expressions on them. So we can see our expression on here, and it says time times 120. So instead of hard coding the number 120 into this expression, I want this control to actually set what number we're multiplying by, times by. So what I'm going to do is erase this, and we are now going to use the pick whip button here. This pick whip button, you can tell it looks exactly like the one in the parent column, and it works the same way. You know, the parent column lets you parent this layer to this layer by just picking it and letting go. So what we're going to do is say we want to multiply time times, and we're going to make sure you use this pick whip in the expression area, and we're going to pick whip it to this slider. And it doesn't work if you try to connect it to the effect itself. It has to be to the value within that effect. And you can see that After Effects automatically typed all this stuff in. And this is basically saying time times this comp, meaning this composition that we are in, the layer named controls, the effect named clock speed, slider. So you can see it basically just starts very wide, the entire comp, and it gets narrower, narrower, narrower until it's literally pointing to this exact slider in this effect on this layer. This is the way After Effects writes out sort of the address of this, if you will. So we're going to add the semicolon, hold command, and hit return. And the slider is set to 0 right now, but let's say I set that back to 120. So now the minute hand is moving again at exactly one rotation every 3 seconds. But if I change this to, say, 10, now it's moving very slowly. See? So now what's great about this is I can basically copy this expression. I can just click in the box and hit Command-C or Control-C on a PC. I'm going to hit U on the hour hand. I'm going to erase this expression and paste the other expression in there. Now, we don't want the hour hand to move exactly the same speed as the minute hand, obviously. We've decided we need it to move 12 times less than the minute hand. So what we're going to do is have this expression say time times all of this stuff, basically pointing to this slider value, and then we're going to divide by 12. So you can see you can have multiplication and then division, and you can basically type in a long string that will sort of do all this math for you and arrive at the value and give you what you want. So command enter, and now you can see that the hour hand is moving at the right speed. So here we are at 12 o'clock. The minute hand goes all the way around. Now we're at 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock. And the great thing is that now, if we want the clock to go faster, all we have to do is set this number to something else. If we wanted it to go faster, we could say 200. And it will go faster, but it will still work. Like the amount that the hour hand moves relative to the minute hand will always stay correct, because we've set up the expressions to do that for us automatically. So this is a very small example of the power of expressions, but hopefully it'll get your brain thinking a little bit about ways to speed up your work by using this. Again, if you were going to keyframe this and have it be precise, it would be pretty tricky. And then if your client came to you and said, yeah, the clock looks great, but can it go about 15% faster? Well, that would be really tricky if you had keyframes, and you'd have to do some math and you'd have to do some trial and error. And, you know, with this, all you have to do is, you know, change this number, change it to something else. And now the clock goes slower or faster, however you want it to work. So that was the introduction to expressions. Hopefully now you know how to apply expressions. You know how to look for expressions in the dictionary. And you know that you can always go up to help and hit expression reference and read about the expressions there. And I hope moving forward, this provides the foundation you need to start using expressions in After Effects. Thank you guys so much, and I'll see you guys soon. Thanks for watching. I hope you learned a ton from this lesson and that you're now way more comfortable with expressions than when you started. If you have any questions or thoughts, let us know. And we would love to hear from you if you use expressions on a project. So give us a shout on Twitter at School of Motion and show us your work. And if you learned something valuable from this video, please share it around. It really helps us spread the word about School of Motion, and we truly, truly appreciate it. Don't forget, sign up for a free student account to access project files from the lesson you just watched, plus a whole bunch of other awesome stuff. Thanks again, and I'll see you next time.